Planet X, a viewer has a vision. I get a lot of messages from viewers who want me to know about their dream. They think I want to hear about their dreams. But actually, I don't. Dreams mean nothing. Dreams are nothing more than a pigment of your immigration. So I write back, nice dream. There are a lot of YouTube channels out there, and you're missing out. In other words, send your dreams to someone else, please. After a few hundred of those, I get one like this. It's Tina from Washington State. She had a vision and didn't really understand it, and so she spent some time at my channel watching Planet X videos and says it helped her understand her vision. Ooh, that's chilling. She gets a vision, doesn't understand it, and then studies my YouTube videos and understands her visions? This is scary. She writes, first I took the time to watch some of your videos last night. Thank you for your work. They have helped me make sense of what I saw. Bad news is now. You have no reason to believe me, because a lot of what I saw, you have done videos on. I'm not psychic, and cannot predict the future. I have always had an instinct that never fails, mostly dealing with family health and animal behavior. I do not claim anything I am saying will happen, only that I believe I personally received some kind of warning and message. I have done a lot of research, so now I'm not sure how much that has impressed on my memory. So I will try to keep to the original vision dream. I was awakened from my bed and told to come outside. It was daylight and warm outside. There was a big red ball in the sky where the sun would have been, east. I did not see the sun. I was very confused and shaking my head. I kept saying, "What?" Then a screen appeared in front of me, and Obama was addressing the people. He seemed almost joking about it at first. It was a long speech, and here are the highlights. He called it a brown dwarf failed planet. He said they did not see it because it was out of our plane, that it was the cause of the bad weather, that they believed it would cause a pole shift. He went on to explain what a shift was, and it would cause a great deal of death and destruction. He was quoting God a lot and saying prayers. He said we had a few weeks until the actual shift happens, but the weather was expected to get much worse as the time grew nearer. He tells us to stay in our homes, and he is enacting martial law, and no one is to leave their homes after 10 p.m. and before 6 a.m. No travel is allowed. Banks will be closed, and business except healthcare will be closed. He then states, every community will have the opportunity to have a tracking device implanted in them so they could find the survivors and supply them with food and medical supplies. Yeah, right. He talks about identifying bodies and giving peace to the family. That's how they sell it to the public. He also says they will be collecting a database of DNA for identification processes. For identification purposes. He talks at great length about how they will remove the chips and destroy all the DNA after the recovery efforts. Not to worry, this is not a government conspiracy theory. Well, I still have a Social Security card that says right on it, not to be used for identification. Try to open a bank account today without giving them your Social Security number. I don't trust government. And I don't want it, their goddamn chip. Back to the message. That they need to find survivors and they need to find them fast. They don't give a rat's ass about us. Who is she kidding? This is propaganda. So they can help. Yeah, help this. He closes with, may God be with us all. The Antichrist talks about God. Give me a break. And then she writes, I then saw soldiers everywhere. Total chaos, riots, burning buildings, people being killed. They showed on the screen like pictures flashing. Boy, I'd like to meet these aliens. Take a look at my future. She writes, next I was bouncing on the ground like a basketball. Well, those Bible thumpers out there should be thrilled to hear that. The Bible says the earth will shake like a hut. And she says, and my house was falling apart. Everything came down, barns and all. I saw the sun rising from the west many times. Sorry, I did not count. Then I saw the sun start to come up, but it did not. It just stayed dusk for a while. Days, I think. I felt very heavy, like I couldn't hardly move. The red ball was to the left of the sun. The ground was shaking the entire time, but not as bad as the first one. I was very disoriented. Then all was calm for a few minutes. Then the wind. All the debris flying. I don't have words for it, and I've never seen anything like it before. I knew it was the wind that I needed to protect myself from. Try the debris. Then I was standing there like nothing had happened on my back porch. I had a conversation that went something like this, that I did not want to survive. I was going to get drunk and hope a giant rock fell on my head. I was told it would be easy to die and hard to live, that I needed to survive to protect the children. Then I woke up in a sweat and very confused. I don't have any children. I don't know what children, who or what I am to protect them from. I go to bed every night asking for clarity. No answers as of today. I did not see anything to do with oceans or water, only what happens on my property. I think just what I will personally deal with. I live in Washington and am about 1,800 feet level, probably above sea level. So I don't believe I will deal with flooding. I also don't remember volcanoes going off, although I suspect they will. I did see red dust blowing everywhere. I bought eye goggles and face masks. I did not see how long before Earth returns to some kind of normal or how we will survive. I did get a sense that the government was the real problem and I needed to pay close attention to their actions. Now this part is just knowledge that I woke up with. It was not told to me. There will be help from the skies for the people, and the government will fail. They are going to blow up Obama's bunker. So don't accept a ticket. That is why I didn't think I was talking to God. It was aliens, I think. I did not see who I was talking to. Hope this helps you in some way. I only told you this because some of your videos have helped me come to a place of peace. Just maybe I'm not going crazy. For that, I thank you. I never intended to put the dream out there, only to help people with the water problem. See, most people don't know that the charcoal in a water filter is not match light. Peace to you and yours. P.S. December 21st, 2012, I don't think so. I would say from the weather, it was early March, although I could be wrong since it's around 60 degrees today. There should be snow on the ground this time of year. So I read this, and I got up off the floor after reading it, and I wrote back, "This is fascinating writing. You should make a video about this vision. If you don't, may I read this for a video? It's very good. Back to Constitution." And she writes back, "Yes, you're welcome to do as you please with the information. Please don't use my last name. I know it's on my YouTube as my username. I am new to YouTube and did not know they would print my full name. It's too late for me to do videos. It takes time to develop a following, and I need to dig a hole in the ground. Went on a seed buying trip yesterday. Do you know how hard it is to find seeds in December? Also bought a book on seed saving. called Seed to Seed by Suzanne Ashworth. Now I need to concentrate on how to survive. I'm very lucky. I have a small backhoe, steel horse trailers. My plan is to dig a big hole in the hillside and bury them. We will see how that goes. Let's call it Plan A. I don't have a Plan B yet. How do you plan for such an event? Just watched another of your videos. This one had new telescope infrared image of what I saw. I would say the only true recent image on the net. I went to his channel and watched a few other of his videos. He seems to be a good net gatherer of information. I asked him what date he thought the pole shift would be. March 22nd, 2013, his answer. Now folks, please don't attribute that answer to me. I'm reading what she wrote, and she got this from somebody who has videos on YouTube or on the internet. This is not my date, please. Returning back to her writing, if you read it to your viewers, could you add this? I heard Nancy say, put your pets down. Please do not do this. Well, that was back in 2003. Dogs have better hearing than humans and can warn you when someone is about to kick your door down, giving you a fighting chance. Gee, she must have her door kicked down a lot. Jeez. She says, cats know an earthquake is coming long before you can feel it. Well, how does the dog tell you that someone's about to kick your door down? They bark at everybody outside. And when a cat senses there's an earthquake, what exactly does the cat say to you to let you know that an earthquake is coming? Well, she's probably reading the body language or communicating telepathically with her dogs and cats. I don't know. She says this could give you the chance to get out of your house before it falls down. Yeah, let me get out there with all the debris flying at 300 miles an hour, because I just love to see roofs coming at me. I like to try to dodge them, see if I can jump up in the air and have them go under my feet and get hit by a school bus instead. So she advocates here at the end, so if you don't have a cat and a big dog, go get one. Thanks for listening. Peace to you and yours. Well, you know what will happen is people will get a dog, they won't be able to feed the dog, and they'll end up eating the dog when they have nothing else to eat. So, I don't know how useful any advice is. She talks about big rocks falling on people's heads, and I think that's a very real possibility. I have never been through a pole shift, and neither have you. And the only thing we have to go on is what the ancients wrote. And apparently they experienced at least one pole shift. And when you go back to the one before that, it's so long ago, nobody wrote anything 7,200 years ago. I don't know if there's a Planet X. I just thought that this letter was very interesting, and I thought you might enjoy it. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Immigration. So I write back, nice dream. There are a lot of YouTube channels out there, and you're missing out. In other words, send your dreams to someone else, please. After a few hundred of those, I get one like this. It's Tina from Washington State. Understands her visions? This is scary. She writes, first, I took the time to watch some of your videos last night. Thank you for your work. They have helped me make sense of what I saw. Bad news is now. You have no reason to believe me, because a lot of what I saw, you have done videos on. I'm not psychic and cannot predict the future. I have always had an instinct that never fails, mostly dealing with family health and animal behavior. I do not claim anything. She had a vision and didn't really understand it, and so she spent some time at my channel watching Planet X videos and says it helped her understand her vision. Ooh, that's chilling. She gets a vision, doesn't understand it, and then studies my YouTube videos and Planet X, a viewer has a vision. I get a lot of messages from viewers who want me to know about their dream. They think I want to hear about their dreams. But actually, I don't. Dreams mean nothing. Dreams are nothing more than a pigment of your